and dishwater gives back no image.
Ozahlezi phi kawuleze skotuge nalizulu liyatuma yegale mbongolo siqhubiza inkomo skotuge
dance naked on the palm tree.
and see the man. His back facing me. His shoulders towards the sun, he is without motion transfixed. His eyes locked ahead. The statue breaks. His jacket slips over his wrist and flows down like water to his lips. The brown tooth completes the look of the scarecrow. He leaves us, step by step into his oversized boots as if the rain ahead of him. The weight of him settles. It's dry and hot. So hot you hear the sharp stings of the waves beating against the sand. He shields himself, a humble straw hat for armor. The air is thick and still. Suddenly the body ahead began to crank into action, slowly starting to lumber into an upstanding flow. His ox-like shoulders roll with the thud of every step. He wears a head, worn by that same sun. I want to follow him. It feels like I should know this man. It feels like I've always known this man. I should be afraid of the imposing figure, but somehow there's a blanket of inexplicable comfort. His body sings a rhythm as he walks. His giant boots shovel through the sun, they sand. I cannot seem to catch up. I am wading through the thick of the air. My joints are tired. This song gets further and further away. The tune begins to strain. The further he gets, the harder I breathe. My nostrils fill with sand. I open my mouth to try to breathe easier. I cannot breathe. I am suffocating. My lungs are drowning in mud. And all I see is the shimmer on the horizon, the fading image of that man. I call like a child, he doesn't answer. I call again. I call till my throat salts with blood. I call till all I can do is cry for my grandmother. Uma, Willie.
He just wants what's best for his daughter.
He is right to do so. He is, after all the richest men in the village. What do you offer a man with the greatest treasure among his people?
You are kind.
You are beautiful. I'm going to fight by the riverside. Will you come?
I have duties.
I will be brief.
You're either very confident or very bad.
And how do you think I fare?
With fighting or this game?
Whichever has the greatest prize.
Either way, you're still a boy playing games.
They laugh gently.
Solo reaches out with the same gesture from the bond they made in the cave as young children. As he does so, Buitumelo's father appears.
Mohalo!
Papa!
I'm off to fight by the riverside if you care to be entertained.
We see a man from before emerge with a jacket. He says the following, parts of which are echoed by the chorus.
Yeah, but we don't have a chorus.
Ivan, I thought you understood what we're doing.
We are reading stage directions. We didn't even learn our lines. It feels like a chicken. Why didn't Dominic and Tanta just say they don't have a budget to do this thing?
This is avant-garde, like Sarah Kane, like Carol L. McLean. This is new experimental work. And if you want real theater with a capital letter T, go to Newtown. This is Mama Lee.
How fitting to have a deal? Ke bona ke thube ga go tswa mo lefatsheng la botlhokomogi. Le mongwe a letleletseng go ka ikela boya borwa, a boe gape go batlana le boteng jo bo setseng boitsagale mo go rona. Ga ke sa itse lefatsheng le ke leng mo go lone, ke ipotsa dipotso, dipotso tsotlhe tsa mehutabuta. Ke dumela mo lefatsheng le feng? Lefatshe la me ke le feng? Boteng jwa me bo mo teng ga boteng jwa me. Boteng jwa boteng jwa me bo mo teng ga boteng jwa me.
So, we start to echo each other in movement. And then the voice follows automatically, mumbling. And then this starts making me think. There's visual synchronicity, vibrational unison, and then my body starts to let go, and then it gravitates towards stomping. And then this made me think of the sound of the car. Womela wa nuka, wole shata la meti, womenori ya bana, womu mkwa mtu. You know, I don't know, but it feels like there's something more at work here.
Yeah, I get it with Jim Andre. My spirit is in my shoes. If it were up to me, I would glide to walk heads. Floating is better, but also the memory of my people is with me. And how do I pull the ground towards the ground? The ball is not on the pitch anymore.
You will never marry into them. In fact, I never want you to see that boy again. We are moving across the river.
The father exits, and Mokhalo turns to discover Simba.
Across the river. But those lands are of white men.
And worse more, I am never to see you again.
I cannot believe that your father would be so harsh.
I did not think of him capable.
For 5 years now. For 5 years, I've done all in my power to win this man. I've made my heart known to him. I offered him more cows than the cost of 4 wives. I've tended his fields in his service, and he's beating my honor in this way. I shall be disgraced. What shall we do? What is there to do now? Oh, and they warned me about your father, but I will not listen like a fool.
Who warned you?
That's
what?
Later now.
Well, what was that, Sinlo?
The elders of my family said your father came is a curse.
What?
Yes, because he has abandoned his ancestors to follow the white man's God. That is why his feet cannot find rest in one place. That is why he cannot bear more children or take more wives. Why must I suffer for your father's emptiness? Rahu is bitter.
Do you believe that?
Well, what am I to believe after this?
You know, it's so easy for you and your family to act all high and mighty in my face. When the white men come and ride on their horses, you cower. You plead to prevent him from war. You give him what he wants, haunted by the voices in the wind that tell of their demise. And before you know it, you give it all away, and before you know it, he simply has to blow hard enough for you to fall. Where are the great grazing lands in the praise poems of your father? Sold as plea bargains for false peace? I have seen all of this, and it does not end well for your people.
And so the naked truth is unmasked. Mohalo. Our world is so different now. We cannot hold on what we hope to be as children.
Sinlo exits, and Mohalo follows.
I like that scene.
Yes,
I
see.
Come on,
man.
Shame, man.
Alfred.
Oh.
Alfred, what be? Alfred, I, Billy Edward,
yes,
would like you to bite your ankle. Oh, okay. I would like you to take your teeth out, place them beneath your feet, have your neck up. Billy Edward,
yeah?
I want you to run faster and breathe slow. I want you to jump up high and never come back.
So whenever you think, well, you can plunge away with the soil and grow a carrot.
I want you to drink all the waters of the land, the oceans, Pacific, Indians, and all the other ones, and all the rivers, and the lakes, and the dams, and the tap water, and all the wine, and never quench your thirst.
I want you to cut this hair out of your armpits using your teeth.
I want you to grow all this hair beneath your feet.
Yes.
I want you to take your head and place it under your heels.
I want you to have these eyes behind your ears.
I want you to cook soil with milk and eat it through your anus.
I want you to eat all the soil and all the trees and let them grow from your body.
I want you to...
Now we're both feeling tired. We hear the sound of horses and bugles in the darkness. Villagers with the lust of their belongings running from the onslaught. A figure holding a jacket.
Janum Leto Lissimulu. Samaya, I didn't know that how much we don't got it. Ah, but I think that we are prepared. But I feel all that we are not cool, so the fellow let me move the villa down, go my friend. The people that are the bits are the yellow.
Then the figure discovers sand in the pockets of the jacket.
We grew tired and could not continue from. Well, Dominic, I know that you want the translation of this. I'll give it to you now. A place we grew tired and could not continue from. Displaced and divided. Once you have retraced all that we were, you will find the place of our birth. The place where the sand danced at our feet and the winds called our names. The place where the river fed our veins and the heavens smiled warmly on us. That place you will find rest. At that place, you will understand. From then on, you will be the instrument of our memory. You will free us, and in turn, we will free you from the heaviness of our grief.
Scene 2.
Okay.
Friday morning, June 20, 1913, the South African native finds himself not actually a slave, but a pariah in the land of his birth.
Say to Jula, no more. joking.
Awesome.
Shalom.
And see her in the